Jai Hind, my dear students. Good morning, and once again I welcome you to your English class. Children, you already know that your exams are going to start from 3rd of March, right? And I have already posted the syllabus with you, so you also have got the syllabus. In the syllabus, if I talk about the syllabus, then most of the chapters and topics are covered. So few more topics that are left, children, we are going to complete it by this week or maybe by the next week. After the completion of the course, we are going to start the revision work. Okay, children? So we are not having much of time, so I would request all of you that you should start paying attention more. I know that you had been paying attention towards the classes, but then now you should pay more attention to the classes, because children, now we will be telling you so many things, so many facts that will help you to gain good marks in exam during the classes, right, children? So today, to start the class, children, I'm going to start the class by a new topic. Yes, so today we are going to start a new lesson, children, from our literature book. Everybody is having your literature book, this Magic Lantern book. So from this Magic Lantern book, in today's session, we are going to first read a story from this, from one of the chapter of Magic Lantern, right? And let me just see the page number so that I can mention it. Yes, children. So it's on page number 100, right? It's on page number 100 and lesson number is 11. And the name of the chapter is Rainmaking. Yes, so Rainmaking. I would like to ask you, children, that what do you understand when I say the word Rainmaking? What do you think that what can be, what story it can be about? Like what all comes in your mind? Like the story may be related to rain, right? And related to monsoon season, right? So you can guess like this, right? But children, let me tell you, there is some really interesting situations that are going to occur during the story, and you are going to love to listen to the story. So without wasting time, I will straight away share the screen of mine so that we can start reading the story. So children, here it is, lesson number 11. This is what we are going to start with. Okay, so lesson number 11, let me just zoom it. I will zoom a little bit so that I guess now it's quite visible to every one of you, right? I hope that this is visible, right? So Rainmaking is the chapter's name, and this story is written by Ravi Shankar, right? Keshav Shankar, right? Keshav Shankar Pillai is the writer or the author of this story, and the story is about a small boy, children. Okay, it's about a small boy who is none other than the author of the story, that is Keshav Shankar Pillai. When he was a child, when he was in childhood days, so he has memorized one of his memories, and he is sharing one of his memories of childhood memories to all of us, right? And I'm sure that you are going to enjoy listening to this story. So let's get set, go. Have you ever tricked your parents or friends? For example, did you pretend to be ill, then laughed when your parent got worried? Have you ever done so, children? Did you hide your friend's notebook, then watch the fun as he/she looked for it? How did your parent and your friends react? What did they tell you when they found that you had played a trick on them? So, children, generally what happens whenever we are playing trick with our, you know, parents or something with our friends, they generally get worried about it. People who are, you know, people who care for us, they get worried about us, right? So children, the story is about a boy whose name is Raja, okay, and how he plays tricks with his grandparents and how he make them worried. Okay, so the whole situation is narrated by the author himself, and he is actually telling you one of his sweet memories of childhood, right? So let us now hear this, listen to the story. Okay, a little boy played a naughty trick on his grandfather. How did you think the grandfather reacted? Read the story to find out. Okay, so let's then start it. It was evening after a heavy rain. Grandfather, just a second children. I'm going to choose a color so that if anything comes important, I can underline it. Okay. It was evening after a heavy rain. Grandfather was picking flowers from the jasmine bush. Okay. What is now jasmine bush? Do you know, children? Jasmine is a flower. Okay, jasmine is a flower, white color flower, and it smells really very nice. It has a distinct smell, lovely scent it has, right? So grandfather was picking up flowers from the jasmine bush under a sandalwood tree. Now what do you mean by sandalwood, children? Sandalwood means, jise hum hindi mein chandan kehte hain. You all know ki chandan ki lakdiyan bahut, they are expensive, right? And at the same time, a very strong scent emits from it, right? So jab aap use rub karte hain, agar aap us pe thodi si pani, chandan ki lakdi mein pani dal kar, aur agar aap use ghisna shuru karenge, so you start getting a paste of it, right? And if you smell that paste, wo bahut bahut hi strong smell hoti hai, and it is very nice, bahut acha hota hai, right? So there was a jasmine bush under a sandalwood tree, and grandfather was picking up the flowers, okay, after a heavy shower in the evening. The leaves of the tree were full of raindrops. So as because there was a heavy rainfall in the evening, so the leaves of the trees, they were full of raindrops. I knew I could make rain if I shook the tree. It would be great fun. So now children, here when somebody is saying I here refers to the author. Who is I? I here refers to the author, that is Mr. Shankar Pillai, right? So Shankar Pillai, who is right now known as Raja in this story. So Raja thought that I can make rain if I shake this tree, as because due to heavy rain, the leaves are full with raindrop. So if I shake the tree hard, then it is going to rain. It will seem like it is raining, right? So it would be a great fun. So he wanted to play a prank with his grandfather, and so he thought of this plan, right? So I quietly went near the sandalwood tree and shook it up all my strength, right? So now the author is saying that I went near the sandalwood tree and I shook it to my full strength. And then what was the result of it? There was a heavy shower and both grandfather and I were soaked, right? So what happened? What was the result of, shaking that tree? The result was that a heavy shower or lots of raindrops fall down, and both grandfather as well as Raja got soaked. Soaked means became wet, right? They got wet, right? I loved it, but grandfather turned on me with an angry look. I was sure he would catch me and beat me, so I ran. So now the author is saying that I was very happy. I enjoyed getting wet in the rain, but then my grandfather did not like it, and he got red out of anger, and I was sure that if he catches me, then surely he is going to beat me, and he is going to scold me too. So that's why I ran from there. I just ran away from that place so that grandfather cannot catch me. He could not catch me, right? So that's what he did. Now next, children, what happened? I ran away to the paddy fields and hid myself there. So now what did the author do? Author, he ran away from there and he hid himself in the paddy fields. Now what is paddy fields, children? Paddy fields means it's a type of grain, rice grains. So where the rice grains are grown, so that area or that field where the field, in that field when the rice grains are grown, so that field is called as paddy fields, right? So he hid himself into the paddy fields. I heard grandfather shout that he would teach me a lesson when I came back home. So grandfather shouted as he ran, as he saw Raja running away from him. Grandfather shouted loudly that he is gonna teach him a lesson as he comes back home, right? It was now he was kept himself hidden in the paddy field till it was getting dark, till evening, right? Now, children, throughout the day when he hid himself in the paddy field, and soon it was about the time to sunset, and that's why it was getting dark, right? So what did the author do then next? I stood up, looked around and then ran towards home. Tab author ne kya kaha ki main utha and I just ran towards home. Main bhaga apni ghar ki taraf. I went to the cow shed and took shelter in the loft. Now the author said ki main cow shed ki taraf bhaga. What is cow shed? Cow shed means where cows are red, the home, the place of where the cows are red or they stay there is called as cow shed. And he took a shelter. He said that maine shelter liya, wahan jaakar sharan liya, kahan par? Loft mein. Now what is loft, children, do you know? Loft is just below the, you know, roof ke niche, jo below the roof jo room hota hai, that is generally used for as a storehouse or as a warehouse to keep extra items. So that place, that room is called as loft, right? So generally not in India, but if you go to foreign countries or if you go to European countries where or to the snowy areas where they the houses are have a sloping roof. So the sloping roofs, they have a loft on the upper side, and that room is called as loft, where it is used as a storehouse, right? From there, I could see grandfather sitting on the veranda and saying his prayers. So now the child says that main wahan se apne grandfather ko dekh pa raha tha ki grandfather was sitting in the veranda. Now what is veranda, children? An open courtyard, right? Jahan upar aisa khula hua open area jo space ghar ke bahar hota hai, use hum veranda kehte hain, right? And he was saying his prayers. He was just praying. Grandfather was waiting grandfather was waiting for Raja. So she went to grandfather and asked, where is the little one? Who you look for him in the house? Grandfather said. So now what happened? Grandmother, she was waiting for Raja to return back. She was waiting for him, but as because it was too late and Raja did not return, so she went to grandfather and she asked grandfather that where is the little one, right? What did grandmother ask? She asked, where is the little one? Little one ka meaning yahan pe kisko refer kar raha hai beta, bataiye aap, who is referred as little one here? The little one is referred to Raja, the child, right? So grandfather replied, you look for him in the house. घर पर उसे देखो, मुझसे क्यों पूछ रही हो? Grandfather was little angry with that. I looked for him everywhere. मैंने उसे हर जगह देखा, right? The grandfather stood up and went outside and called aloud, come Raja, come, I won't beat you. So grandfather, as because it was started getting dark, grandfather now just thought, as because grandmother said ki wo to ghar par kahin nahi hai, I have searched him everywhere. So grandfather, he stood up, went outside and cried loudly, zor se chillaya. He said that come raja, wapas aa jao raja, main tumhe nahi marunga, I won't beat you, main nahi marunga tumhe. Grandmother was angry and said, I heard you say that you would beat him if he came back, came home. Poor child, he's afraid of you and has run away. So now grandmother was very angry at grandfather and said that I heard you saying that you would beat him. मैंने सुना तुम कि तुमने उसे मारने की बात कही थी. And that's why he did not return back home. और इसलिए वो घर वापस नहीं आया. Poor child, वो आपसे डर रहा है. And that's why he ran away. और इसलिए वो भाग गया. Grandfather called the servants and asked them to go out and look for him. Grandfather ने servants को बुलाया और उन्होंने क्या कहा? उनको कहा कि जाइए ढूंढिए बच्चा कहाँ है, राजा कहाँ है. They went out, but after a while returned to say that they would not find me. Right? वो कुछ देर बाहर गए, ढूंढा और उसके बाद वो वापस आए और उन्होंने कहा कि वो लोग सक्षम नहीं है. They were not capable to find राजा. वो मुझे ढूंढ नहीं पाए. Grandmother started weeping. Grandmother, अब उनको राजा की बहुत चिंता होने लग गई. She was worried about Raja, so she started weeping. Weeping means crying, right? Grandfather started walking up and down the courtyard. अब grandfather तो रो नहीं सकते, but then he was worried about Raja, so he started walking up and down. वो ऊपर नीचे courtyard में करने लग गए, right? The news that I was missing spread. Our neighbors came first, then our relatives and others who had heard the bad news. Many came to offer their sympathies to grandmother. बहुत सारे लोग आए sympathy देने के लिए, बहुत neighbors आए, उसके बाद relatives आए, and everybody was coming to offer their sympathies to grandmother. Grandmother को sympathy दिखाने, अच्छा अच्छा okay okay बहुत बुरा हुआ, like this. So everybody was sympathizing grandmother. Grandfather did not like this. He shouted. Grandfather को बिल्कुल ये पसंद नहीं आया and he shouted, nothing has happened to the boy. Can't someone of you go out and look for him instead of wasting your time here? So grandfather got quite pissed off because he was just amazed to see that all these people, the neighbors, relatives, they are all coming to just sympathize us, but nobody is actually, you know, thinking to go out and search Raja. So that made grandfather little angry about these people. Some of them went out to search for him. कुछ उनमें से गए भी ढूंढने के लिए. The search parties returned without finding me. सर्च पार्टी सारे जो जो ढूंढने के लिए गए थे, कोई मुझे ढूंढ नहीं पाया और सब वापस ऐसे ही आ गए. Grandmother started weeping loudly. They behaved as if I were dead. वो सब इस तरह से बिहेव कर रहे थे कि जैसे ऑथर को लगा कि जैसे कि मैं मर गया हूँ. I am dead. And they all started behaving like that. I felt very sorry for grandmother. मुझे अपनी grandmother के लिए बहुत बुरा लग रहा था. I wanted to come out. मैं वापस आना चाहता था. Grandfather was a man of strong will. मेरे जो grandfather थे, वो एक strong will means दृढ़ इच्छा शक्ति, दृढ़ संकल्प, दृढ़ इच्छा शक्ति वाले इंसान थे. He did not lose hope. उन्होंने बिल्कुल होप नहीं हारी थी. He stood up, turned in the direction of our family temple and prayed. वो खड़े हुए एंड ही वो टर्न किया उन्होंने टुवर्ड्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फैमिली टेंपल. हमारा जो फैमिली टेंपल था जहाँ हम प्रे करते थे, वो वहाँ गए और वो गॉड से प्रे करने लगे. हेल्प मी गॉड. व्हाट डिड ही प्रे? ही सेड टू गॉड दैट हेल्प मी गॉड. ही सेड, गिव मी माय चाइल्ड. मेरा बच्चा मुझे वापस दे दो. आई वॉन्ट हिम नाउ. मुझे अभी अभी के अभी मेरा बच्चा वापस चाहिए. आई कैन नॉट वेट. So he said, help me God, give me my child, I want him now, I cannot wait. He then stood silent in prayer. और ये बोलकर वो बिल्कुल eyes close करके prayer में silent हो गए. At that moment, uncle returned. उसी समय उसी मोमेंट पर अंकल वापस आए. He learned what was happening at home. उनको सब बात पता चली कि घर पर क्या चल रहा था. He looked around and guessed where I was. उन्होंने चारों तरफ देखा और उन्होंने गेस किया कि मैं कहाँ हो सकता हूँ. He came to the cow shed and asked to me to come down. वो cow shed के पास आए और उन्होंने मुझे बोला वापस आओ राजा, चलो उतरो नीचे. I came down. मैं उनकी आवाज़ सुन के नीचे आया. Uncle took me into the house. और अंकल मुझे घर के अंदर लेकर गए. Grandfather has just finished his prayer. Grandfather ने तभी ही बस prayer over किया था, complete किया था, finish किया था. As he opened his eyes, जैसे ही उन्होंने अपना prayer complete करके eyes open किया, he saw me standing before him. उन्होंने देखा मुझे कि मैं ठीक उनकी आँखों के सामने खड़ा हूँ. He took me up in his arms in joy, hugged me and said, उन्होंने तुरंत मुझे अपने बाहों में, अपने arms में ले लिया खुशी से और मुझे हग किया. He hugged me tightly and said, God heard my prayers and has given you back to us. God ने मेरी prayer सुन ली और देखो तुम्हें हमको वापस कर दिया. So this was the story that is adapted from Life with Grandfather by written by Keshav Shankar Pillai. Right? So the moral of the story is, children, our parents and grandparents, they love us, they take care of us. We should not make them worry about us. Right? Sometimes children we feel ki humko lagta hai ki hamare parents ya hamare grandparents unnecessary humko daat rahe hain, hamesha har cheez ke liye hame tokte rehte hain. But remember this children, it is for our well-being. Hamari salamati ke liye, hamari khushi ke liye wo sari cheeze hoti hai. Because as aap chote hain to aap apni चीज़ों को नहीं जान सकते हैं कि आपके लिए क्या सही है क्या गलत है. बट योर पेरेंट्स, योर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, दे नो दैट व्हाट इज राइट एंड व्हाट इज रॉन्ग फॉर यू. राइट नाउ लेट्स नो अबाउट द ऑथर केशव शंकर पिल्लई. बॉर्न इन 1902 एंड डाइड इन 1989. बेटर नोन एज शंकर वॉज अ वेल नोन cartoonist. His aim in life was to always make people laugh and enjoy life. He set up a children's book trust with publishers, exciting books for children. In 1968, he began a magazine called Children's World, which is still popular today. Shankar's Life with Grandfather continues to entertain children even today. Right? It was such a nice story, children. And it's a wonderful story. You should learn a good lesson from this. And the lesson is, children, that never ever we should, do anything which will make our parents or our grandparents worried about us, right? Because hamesha hi hamare parents ho ya hamare grandparents ho, hamare liye worried hamesha rehte hain. राइट हमारे लिए हमेशा परेशान रहते हैं. हमने खाया कि नहीं, हमने सोया टाइम पर कि नहीं, हम उठे कि नहीं, हमने अच्छे से कपड़े पहने हैं कि नहीं, हमें कहीं ठंड तो नहीं लग रही है, हमें कहीं गर्मी तो नहीं लग रही है, हमने सब पढ़ाई कर पा रहे हैं ना. हमारे हर चीज़ के लिए वो फिक्रमंद रहते हैं. फॉर एवरी स्मॉल थिंग दे आर वरिड अबाउट अस. राइट चिल्ड्रन, सो इट्स आवर ड्यूटी, इट्स आवर रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी कि हम भी उन्हें परेशान ना करें, है कि नहीं. कभी वो हमें परेशान करते हैं, आपको कभी लगता होगा कि वो आपको परेशान कर रहे हैं. कभी बोलते हैं ये मत करो, कभी बोलते हैं वो मत करो, ऐसा नहीं वैसा नहीं, हर चीज़ के लिए टोकते हैं ना. तो आपको कभी कभी चिढ़ होती है, गुस्सा भी आता है आपको, होता है. राइट, इट हैपन्स. बट चिल्ड्रन, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड कि ये आपको हमेशा समझ में बात ये रहनी चाहिए, ये दिमाग में हमेशा बैठा के रखना बेटा कि वो सब कुछ सिर्फ और सिर्फ आपके लिए है. अगर आपको डांट भी रहे हैं तो उसमें भी आपका ही भला है. अगर आपको प्यार कर रहे हैं उसमें भी आपका ही भला है. सो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे नाउ इन दिस सेशन we have read the chapter. Now in the next session, children, we are going to do the book exercises as well as the notebook work. So for this session for this class. I'm going to stop here right now, and we are going to meet again in the next session. Till then, take care and have a great day.